Miss Jane get news from America. Her daughter proudly write. We say she fail her exam, but she pass in there for white. She pass it with her boss, with her workmate them. She pass it with her boss. And a nice white boy she loved the guard with her, like say she pass. But sometimes she feel fretful, and her heart start gallop fast. And she broke out in a cold sweat, just a wonder if she pass. Anyhow, that was done to the ritual rhythm too that they gave me, you know. Yeah. But I love the doubles very much. In fact, last year, no, about 3 years ago, I did a in concert record in London with Kwesi Johnson, Linta Johnson. And well, what really happened, I was doing an in-concert thing, but I asked Linton to come on and some of the other, some of the young doubles, Bloom and others, to come on and do some things. And they did the first part of the first half of the program. And then I made him do a song with me, one of the Jamaican folk songs, you know. And the fellow who was doing the music gave a little reggae beat to it, you know. He did this throughout the whole thing of the Mento, because of course, you know, the record came out of the Mento and out of the Buru. And my dear, I grew up on all that, those rhythms, you know. And quite a lot of the instruments that they use in Rastafarism, like the repeater and the all the things that they do, the drumming, the is kete. The kete, man. The kete is a Maroon thing. I can remember my first visit to Maroon, to compound, was was about 46 years ago, you know. When they of course, people thought in those days that I was quite mad and that my mother was madder. To allow me to be going to all the place on mule back and all, because those days you couldn't drive going to a compound, you know. You had us to go up on mule. Yes, but they had some sure-footed mules, and then they had some strong Maroon man that would just hold the mule head, like, you know, and things would take you right up into compound, man. And when let me tell you something, when you reach up into a compound those days, you don't alight from that mule before you listen to the history of the Maroons. Yes, master. Yes, you know, pat the mule back. They are dead for come off, and they will tell you about themselves and about the whole history of the Maroons. How you see the Maroons boast that they were never slaves because they took to the hills and tormented the British. Which they did, tormented the British until they got the signed the peace treaty and all that. And even when Cudjoe signed the peace treaty, Nanny was very much against it. I researched Maroons, you see. And that when it came to the time that they felt that they wanted a woman hero, heroine, you know, in the national things. And people were rooting for different. I say, Nanny, a lot of us were on the side of Nanny. We had to find a lot of things to back up our arguments. But that Nanny, that woman who was Codger's sister, she was really behind a lot of the things that happened in a compound and at the Nanny Town. Right. She was the same Nanny of Nanny Town. You know, and they told, oh man, when they tell you the tales, you listened, and then they ended up, you know, them take you down from off of the mule and then feed you, and then they blow their bang and they play the kettle drums, you see, and the dance. I can never forget the first thing they were finished with the story. The kettle drum started, and you saw, when you look, you see people coming from all sides of the hill. You know, clear road, oh, Ali folk, I come clear road, oh, clear road, oh, Ali folk, I come clear road, oh, and this get the thing going and them good, and they come. I tell you, know, be ready where you send, call me far, Edo, oh, Edo, oh, where you call me far. I tell you, know, be ready where you send, call me far, and they all move it. And I tell you, so that reggae is so much a part of the whole musical culture of the country. The dance, the whole weekend, you see. I always start my programs with on the stage with what we call the Jamaican welcome song. Come make me hold your hand, and it's a dance. it has set steps and all that. Mm. And there's the strongest step is the younger. And the younger is the reggae. The thing, the whole weak need thing is the younger. And that is the strength of the reggae. That same younger movement. You know?
No, where does that come from originally? I mean, I know it's from Africa. I mean,
well,
in
you
terms
see,
of
well, not Mona was Africa. But then the Ashanti claim this, you know. So many of our people were Ashanti, and there was a strong, there is still a very strong Ashanti sound in our talk. Mm-hmm. Even in the construction of the sentences, you know, where they had a language called tree.
Mm-hmm.
And from that, quite a lot of our words that we still use are from that.
Nyam is one of them.
Mm, Nyam, yeah, mm-hmm. And the Yanga too, mm-hmm. And Bankra,
mm-hmm.
And Kaskas Koskos, Kaskas, Kasa Kasa.
Mm-hmm.
Oh Lord, plenty of words. I mean, I'm going now at the etymology today. I'm very happy when the young dubbers say to me, you know, that mm-hmm. They got inspiration from me. Mm-hmm. As far not only our Jamaican dubbers, you find people like Paul Kings, Douglas and things from Trinidad.
Tim telling me,
well, I got that inspiration when I was a university student and read your works and listened to your performances. So this and the works that they are turning out, I mean, it is a joy to me to listen to most of them. The majority of them are turning out but works of excellence,
mm-hmm.
lot, you know. And in fact, well, and things that are meaningful to the society, to the people of today, and that will live on, and that will be meaningful to many generations to come in Jamaica. And this is what is happening, this whole process, our cultural process. We are culturally emancipated, I think. It is just to work on that emancipation now and really let it be for all, you know, spread it.
Miss Lou, it has been 50 years that you've been in theater and performing in Jamaica. What has that experience been like?
Well, sometimes coffee, sometimes tea, sometimes chicken boar back ready. It was up and down here and there, but I loved every moment of it and I'd do it again. All over, just the same. If I had to choose a career, it would be this.
No changes.
No, me not change a thing. Not into the culture. No, never. Mm. Oh, that was a joy. And now it's 50 years since I got my first professional fee.
Mm-hmm.
You see,
mm-hmm.
And the Jamaica Journal, they're doing a thing about on my 50th year, and they've asked me to write a little thing about it.
Mm-hmm.
So that would just sum up for you
right.
how I feel, I think,
yes.
about it. But I have to go read it, I have to put on my glasses.
That's right.
Because the judge of the group and the mentality, we can't, we never remember all right.
Mm-hmm. And this is called?
Tenk God. I call it Tenk God. Larks is 50 years already. Lots me glad me live to see me and me Jamma culture catch golden jubilee. And dubbers that dub poetry in a the Jamma talk. And movies that make show moving picture in a Jamma talk. Jamma talk gone in a dictionary, Ghana University. Education that take Jamma talk. Some make college degree. And me fling back my remembrance to old time days gone by. When we take king teeth, keep a heart bun. The dry cry out of the eye. For Jamma talk was less counted, low rated, poppy show. But now Jamma talk turn culture, and Jamma culture the flow. In a singing, dancing, painting, in a church and theater show. Jamma culture, in a culture, any part of world we go. Mentor Brookings, Yanga, Sheshe, Bessie Down, the sweet and reggae. And what old time Smaddy used to say, make young Smaddy feel proud today. We all generation doppy them jump, doppy jamboree. When them see how nowadays time, Jamma culture lego free. Tenk God for 50 fruitful years. Tenk God me live for see. Me and me Jamma culture turn golden jubilee.
Thank you, Miss Lou, for being with us here at Reggae Strong, and hope we can do it again.
Neck strong.
Yeah.